Good morning, everyone. Jeremy here with Flatware Creations. I was just making some fork elephants, and I know that some forks, particularly this kind with this pattern, they're thinner, and it seems to be a harder metal. And a lot of times these tines will break off whenever you go to make the trunk. And so I just wanted to kind of give you one of the tricks I use when doing this. So I have two more left to do. I love using the ones that have the patterns on the top of the fork head. But this doesn't always work, but it really helps my chances whenever I'm trying to make the trunks. So let me make sure that I got, okay. So I always do the eyes first. It's just a little bit easier on the in the press, so I don't have to fight with the trunk. So I'm gonna flip this around so I can bend this trunk. I'll generally start out with my graduated pliers. If you don't have those, these work well. Just make sure on these ones that are a lot harder to use the bigger end. So start your turn a little bit bigger, so it's not such a tight turn. That's why I use these, because I can get a nice good round and nice and slow movements. So I've got my turn started there. Don't come down all the way to the bottom down here. Right down here, you want to stay up. Well, I guess it would be down the fork tine quite a bit. So I would say I wouldn't bring it down any farther than right there, or any closer up that way, because as soon as you do, that's almost guaranteed to snap off. It's such a hard bend. So we'll get this guy back in here. Let me turn this a little bit for you. Let's see, can you see that? Okay. So my second turn is after I get that first one, I'm only going to take this down a little bit. These are so finicky and fragile. You can already start to see some little stress marks happen in there. And see how sharp it's bending? It's for that reason that these things break so easy. What I'm gonna do is take my round pliers and I'm gonna turn it just a little bit more. It gives me a little bit rounder shape in there. I'm gonna double check to make sure I'm not about to break. And then I'll take my flat pliers and I'm slowly going to bend this tine out away from the body. So all of this is nice and slow. Gotta bring it down just a touch more. Just nice and slow. Okay, so I don't take it all the way around because a lot of times that's just gonna break right in there. So my twist is actually going down, starting right here. So here's the trick I've been using, is once I get it that little bit, I'll take and I'll lightly hammer it to try and get it to get around that rest of the way. Now I'm gonna take and bend it down a little bit more. Now we've got our bend going. Again, it's not flat, so I'm gonna hammer it. And this time, we're gonna take and run this piece down. So I've got pretty thick piece of my pliers here. that's going to give me enough roundness to not give me that hard edge. And I'm going to lightly bend it over. Then I can take my tip, slowly round it around. And then I'm going to tap it straight down. That's going to give me a little bit more of that trunk coming up. And then we'll give that a little tap to close it up. So, see how far down the trunk is? On this style, that's where I found I need to keep it so that it doesn't break. With other styles, I can take it right up to where it starts to bend right there. But we've been able to save this one. I've had so many of these break on me over the years, and finding out where that point is, it's fairly consistent. But that hammering down process, that's what's really been able to save so many of these pieces. So this one here is a little softer metal. And I'm gonna take my pliers here. Bend that right over. So once I have that first turn, now I can put my pliers wherever I want up the scale here. So wherever I want my turn to start. So I'm gonna take this one down quite a ways. Get it right there, bring this right over, and I'm only going to take it far enough to where I can start my hammering process. Just nice little taps, and then it comes flat. Now I can take and finish that turn the rest of the way. So I can bring it down just like this. Have to get a little bit more width or more of the trunk up. And then if it ends up being to where the hole here for the trunk is too big and it doesn't want to curl around, just grab a smaller pair of your round nose and then help close that up. You can take this, curl it right around, tap it to make sure it's flat. So we've got a nice flat back. If your trunk's twisted one way or another, you can take, just kind of bump it over. There you go, now we got a nice straight trunk. A little bit of character in it. But I just wanted to show you that hammering technique. Instead of just turning it all the way with the pliers, that little bit of hammering, I'm not sure if it's just the slowly heating up as it goes instead of one hard turn. I'm not sure, but I know that it's saved me so many trunks in the past. But I just wanted to share that. Have a good day, everyone.